This is a quagga mussel. It's a dime-sized invader that can clog water and hydroelectric systems and deprive aquatic wildlife of food. They produce 1 million eggs a season and live for 3 to 5 years.
Now they're wreaking havoc here in Lake Mead. As a matter of fact, they led to the hatchery being closed, and they've had massive problems at Hoover Dam where they're getting into the intake pipes and even into the generators in some cases.
So far, the Northwest has not seen any. At Lake Mead, researchers from Portland State University, under contract with the Pacific States Marine Fisheries Commission, funded by the Bonneville Power Administration, are doing what they can to keep it that way.
I'm going to use 7 of these troughs here. Each one will have a different temperature, and within each trough we'll have various calcium treatments using Snake River water, Columbia River water, and Willamette River water. We put the mussels in, let them grow. After 60 days, we pull them out, measure them, see how well they've grown. The whole process will last about 18 months.
It was originally thought that the quagga mussel wouldn't survive in the Columbia, Snake, or Willamette Rivers, but new findings have cause for concern.
We did find out that they could survive in those waters, not as well as in Lake Mead. They didn't grow as quickly. But we also found out that calcium seems to interact with temperature. At warmer temperatures, the higher calcium you have, the less mortality you have as the temperature approaches the thermal limit of the mussels.
Next, the researchers are working on a mathematical model to predict growth potentials so BPA can have an idea of which water bodies need the most protection. But science is just one approach to avoiding an invasion. Everyday objects like shoes, bottles, and boat engines that look like this can have an impact on the public.
You know, this is what happens if you don't check your boat regularly and make sure it's not infested. If this propeller can get this crusty, what's going to happen if you took that propeller and put it into a different lake?
It's important that we do everything that we can to keep quagga mussels from finding their way to the Columbia, Willamette, and Snake Rivers. Not only can they have a devastating economic impact and cost BPA, its ratepayers, and others millions of dollars, but they can also wreak havoc on ecosystems, do damage to fisheries, and have other environmental consequences that we just don't want in the Northwest. Please do everything you can if you have a watercraft or you're a fisherman to make sure that you don't transport any of these mussels into the waters that we're trying to protect.